Ignorant itself is something that is not known to anybody. Nobody knows that they are ignorant.
Mm.
There is something that should be known, that itself is unaware.
Mm. One is unaware.
One is unaware of it completely.
Oh, completely. See, to probe ignorance, when the individual should know that he is ignorant. And what is ignorance? What is ignorance is taking oneself as real. One's body and mind complex is real. Thinking is real. Through thinking, his body, physical body, gains reality. And the world also gains reality. Do you see this, Vivek?
Yes, I do.
Hmm. And the moment one wakes up, see, when actually a human being comes into existence, for everyday life, in our everyday life, one gets up from deep sleep. That is what is one's active part of living. One's waking state is one's active part of living. That is what the whole humanity lives here. That is how it lives here. The individual, the moment he wakes up, how does he wake up? As what he wakes up? He assumes. He takes his body for granted. He thinks he is that, and all the senses are also real. The senses being always at play, in contact with the external world, and perceiving by their nature. He takes them everything. As it is, as one package, both the world real, also himself as real. This is how the movement of thought works in him. Am I right?
Yes.
Normally for a thinking individual, a human being, he is living out a thought. He perceives the world as well as about himself also, within his mind. Whatever the corrections, modifications, changes that take place, he takes them also real. As if he is stationed within the body. And the thinking mechanism with its center is very true for every one of us. This is how the life goes on here. Isn't it?
Yes.
Then at any point in time, will he doubt himself? Is there any chance of doubting his own existence? Can anyone will do that? The moment one wakes up, his sensory organs are always out. All the five sensory organs, they are at play. They are constantly merged in the world with different data being received by the sensory organs, and that also gives a reality. It adds to his physical reality every moment of his waking state, isn't it? Where is the question of he doubting the whole of the existence, including his physical body and his thinking capacity also? How will anyone doubt his thinking capacity? How will anyone doubt his thoughts? This is the crucial question. Which can make him to doubt it? What kind of a thing or a moment, be it externally or within, can make him question about his own existence? To look at closely, will he ever closely examine himself? Will it happen? Leave alone knowing whether one is ignorant or one is made up of what. How will one arrive at this point? First of all, any pain or sorrow of the world, the loneliness of one's life. Loneliness in the sense what? Everyone actually argues, counter-argues within one's own self or anything in this life throughout waking state. Is it not? At any point in time, the intellect, even to go to a place, one is indecisive, one is doubtful whether to go or to avoid, not to go, whether to do or not to do, whether to see, not to see, whether to study or not to study. How to live, one is totally confused. He is always caught between a desire, the mind is caught between a desire and how to get it, this is the way in which, be it a desire or a need or the way one wants to progress in life, everything is actually a psychological gymnastics which is going on in every one of us the moment we come into waking state. How will ye ever come to know, is there anything beyond only this psychological gymnastics? Which will make him to turn and see who is the thinker in him, or why does thinking happen at all? And what are all the psychological satisfactions which he gets by pursuing them? Psychological or physical? See, in both the ways, the mind is always busy. Either following the physical pleasures, one is always busy, psychologically also. Or within one's own psychology, one wants to progress or do something with his own self. How to get more, how to become more, how to understand more, how to acquire more, how to modify, how to advance, as if a separate psychological structure is constantly there in him. And no one ever thinks also there is a state in 24 hours of life that one is totally dissolved, disappears. That is a deep sleep state. And suddenly everything reappears. This is the cycle one constantly goes on. What is the chance or what is the possibility? Because the mind is so trained, the avoiding of pain or sorrow or anything of the not likable content, how to avoid it, that also it is very familiar. And to seek that is pleasurable, that is convenient, that is comfortable, that is gratifying, satisfying, that also the mind is very clever in approaching it. This is going on. This has been going on and this will be going on. Where is the chance of a man coming to know that this is a bull routine and there is nothing new in this, and this has been going on throughout humanity since millennia? How does one come to know about all this? That is my basic premise or question. See, for those who have come to know this is a fiction and they have clearly transcended this one. This is a fiction. Basically, obviously, one can see the whole waking state disappears in deep sleep. That's a simple apparent fact, obvious fact available on the surface of existence. Isn't it? Apparent fact. 18 hours or 19 hours or 16 hours of waking state life with the whole of the cosmos, the knowledge or the ignorance of this existence, both put together, centered around an individual, totally gets disappeared. And only death fear alone is the ultimate fear of the humanity. Which doesn't fall under the thinking limits. One cannot solve it through thinking because it is again a bull routine thinking only. One is trained to think mechanically in the regular bull routine way. How will one come to know? For those who have seen this and clearly seen this as a fiction, totally a non-significant, irrelevant way of arisal and disappearance of every waking state, including the other state, the dream. So what is the amount of importance that is given to dream state? The same way for the waking state also, only that much of importance is given. That is, both are fiction, that's all. How one in the waking state behaves totally in an unconcerned way about the dream that has happened in him. In the same way, for the seers or the souls who have realized, they treat the whole of the waking state also in the same fashion. Though they appear to live and perform their duties and everything as it is expected of them, they don't take this waking state seriously, and with that the death is also kept aside. It is not of any consequence at all, because for an entity which has totally seen this, seen through this, they have transcended all sorts of fears, including the fear of death, because fundamentally they have doubted the existence of the individuality itself, and they have come to the realization there exists no individual at all anywhere in this cosmos. Because if one takes oneself as an individual, you should consider the whole world also something having a separate individuality. The sun has a different, altogether a separate, a unique individuality. The moon has, the earth has, all the five elements, they have individuality. They are not simply names alone. They carry some originality in them. Is there any originality or the individuality, uniqueness throughout the cosmos? This is what is the basic question. You tell me, what's your contention? And and what is the way one is left with? How can one ever think of something beyond this bull routine of waking state coming and disappearing in the deep sleep state, and one fine day the whole of this waking state goes away and one is terribly afraid of this being falling apart? One is constantly want to pursue the continue with the waking state. But whereas it gives up one day, and there is always in every waking state the accumulation process, the gathering process of gathering of knowledge, gathering of possessions, gathering of money, gathering of fame, gathering of physical health, everything. But everything is actually moment to moment falling apart as moments are passing by. As moments pass by, everything is falling apart. But somehow this continuity in one's body and mind as a center, as everyone denoting oneself as I, me, myself, mine, of me, with me, and all these things, these centers, they want everything that are all passing through waking states in and around those centers, and those centers want them to continue. And they struggle, any amount of struggle they are ready to put on that and to have it constantly. Even after death also, in posterity, the names should survive the death, physical death. The name or the wealth or the whatever the possessions that one has acquired, that every one of the center wants it to continue. What is the possibility? In the whole of the cosmos, and whatever we perceive through waking state, the whole world which we call the earth, the five elements, the sun, everything, do they have any unique individuality? And what is it that is working through them, as them, and in us also? If thought is real, if thinking is real, if every possessions, things and what not which we have gathered, if they are real, why everything disappears in the deep sleep? What happens to the mind in deep sleep? Deep sleep is nothing but almost like a death state. Why deep sleep has not been taken as taken to cognizance? Why one has not taken note of it? Why one has not probed into it? Why the mind disappears in deep sleep? With whatever things that one has accumulated throughout the waking state, how and why, with all its content, the mind disappears with the world.